The James Webb Telescope has released new images. Hi everyone, welcome to our channel Space Light. Considerable progress has been made in the development of the James Webb Telescope. Results from the Hubble Space Telescope have put it in the spotlight. As far as the James Webb Telescope is concerned, it's been 25 years since the project was first conceptualized, and things are finally heating up. The European Space Agency has presented 10 stunning new high-definition photographs of stars obtained by the Webb Telescope, utilizing a perfectly aligned space telescope, demonstrating its ability to snap razor-sharp images of the universe with precision even beyond the wildest aspirations of its inventors. It's not clear how the additional images came to be. Has NASA's James Webb Space Telescope been programmed to focus on any particular celestial bodies? How far along are we in the search? In this video, we'll discover out. The James Webb Space Telescope is the most ambitious and advanced space telescope ever built, with a 6.5-meter primary mirror capable of detecting the weak light of distant stars and galaxies. Infrared light released by distant stars, planets, and gas clouds is the primary goal of this instrument. The Hubble Space Telescope's findings will be bolstered by this new telescope, which has a wider range of wavelengths and greater sensitivity. However, James Webb will be able to witness the first stars and galaxies in their infancy from its current location of roughly a million miles away. Since the spacecraft was launched on Christmas Eve last year, NASA researchers have been working non-stop to synchronize its 18 gold mirror segments. Webb's mirror array had to be folded up to fit inside the rocket for launch because of its large size. Finally, after several rounds of testing, both NASA and ESA certified that all of the observatory's image sensors were faultless. NASA has released photographs showing the Webb Telescope's full field of view and deep space to honor the completion of the mirror alignment used to gather light from distant and ancient galaxies. The images were released to mark the completion of the mirror alignment. This image shows all three of the Webb's imaging and spectrographic instruments and its guiding sensor. There are a lot of stars in the enormous Magellanic Cloud, which is 158,000 light-years away from our Milky Way. If it were to orbit our galaxy, it would be the most powerful satellite galaxy in the cosmos. There's no way to know for sure if it's just passing by or if it's slowly merging into our galaxy. As a result, each of the James Webb Space Telescope science instruments captures an image densely packed with stars. As each instrument is shown with the telescope's focal plane, they all gaze at somewhat different parts of the skies. Colors can be reconstructed using images taken by space telescopes. Also, they can be utilized to draw attention to specific aspects. NASA's engineers employed a scarlet color scheme to accentuate the contrast. According to a NASA report on the milestone achievement, the telescope's image resolution is as good as it can be for its size. Only minor adjustments to the primary mirror pieces will be necessary from this point onwards. The telescope has come a long way since its first snapshot in February, which showed 18 distinct golden fuzzy blobs indicating one star. After calibration, the equipment would be able to produce clearer images. Mid-March, this promise was realized with the release of a new image of Ursa Major, a star with a massive crimson spikes. NASA's assistant administrator and former astronaut Bob Cabana told an unrelated briefing that you only see the star if you look at the aligned online snapshot on your phone. Still, some galaxies have never been seen before if you spread them out with your fingers. The James Webb Telescope's infrared photographs will help scientists investigate one of our nearest stellar neighbors, even though they lack some of Hubble's panache. The following instruments were used to capture the LMC image. To begin with Webb's primary set of eyes, the near-infrared camera can view infrared wavelengths that are slightly outside the range of the human eye. In addition, it contains a chronograph that may be used to filter out light from the stars so that planets can be discovered. Mid-infrared detectors can also detect fainter celestial objects such as distant galaxies or comets beyond the range of near cameras. Instruments were being utilized, and their heat would have affected MIRI's sensitivities if it had been any higher than absolute zero. Using an imager and a fine guiding sensor, the near-infrared imager and slitless spectrograph can decompose the light emitted by the scene's objects and determine the scene's composition. For example, the atmospheres of exoplanets could be used to determine whether some Earth-sized worlds are truly Earth-like or whether they're more toxic like Venus or almost devoid of oxygen like Mercury or something else. The fine guidance sensor is required for the Webb to precisely point at an item. Despite fast, weak imaging capabilities, it and its closest function as a single device as the primary eyes. Last is a near-infrared spectrograph, a raw scientific gadget that breaks down light into specific wavelengths, even though it has an image to help guide its operation. When there were only a few heavy components in the early cosmos, this helped Webb scientists discover what was happening. There are numerous detectors, lenses, filters, and other specialist equipment in each instrument to aid in the science. Still, NeoCam and NearSpec will be responsible for most of the cutting-edge research. The wide-field astrophotography photos that will be captured by the MIRI camera are likely to be better than those that will be captured by the Hubble. MIRI's image in particular pops out in the first batch of images. If you look closely enough, you can detect starlight and emissions from interstellar clouds. The observatory's precise guidance sensor calibration photos were also released as a freebie. In reality, it's not there to conduct scientific imaging because it relies on two sensors to position the observatory accurately. To celebrate the alignment with the image of the ESA, NASA released a movie. When individuals worldwide work together with a bold, scientific goal to explore the universe, incredible things can happen, according to Lee Weinberg, manager of NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center's Webb Optical Telescope Element. The research has impacted many people, including the James Webb Space Telescope Wavefront Sensor and control scientist Scott Acton. My role in the James Webb Space Telescope mission has ended after completing telescope alignment and putting in half a lifetime of effort. These photos have had a dramatic impact on my perception of the cosmos. I now perceive the cosmos as a symphony of creation, galaxies galore. I wish that everyone could see them in the world, Acton stated. The $10 billion telescope's next step is unclear. The European Space Agency and the Canadian Space Agency have enabled the James Webb Telescope to see some of the universe's oldest and dimmer stars. Many of the early stars and galaxies were born in the first 300 million years following the Big Bang. In addition, it will be used to peer into the atmospheres of exoplanets, or planets outside of our solar system, by researchers. The discovery of water and methane, for example, may indicate the presence of life or biological activity. Because of the telescope's potential to acquire previously unseen photos of faraway galaxies, we can predict a golden age in our understanding of the cosmos. Following the discovery that the telescope's optical performance is much greater than its most optimistic estimates, the James Webb Space Telescope crew unanimously agreed that its alignment is completed. The team has begun the process known as science instrument commissioning. Once the process is complete, the telescope will be ready to conduct groundbreaking research in around 2 months. During this method, the telescope will be pointed at different places of the sky where the total amount of solar radiation reaching the observatory fluctuates. The temperature of the observatory may be maintained while changing targets. Mirrors will be checked regularly to ensure they are still in the correct position. By the end of June, NASA has announced that it plans to release a collection of jaw-dropping photos to accompany scientific data. The CIA has yet to reveal any specific heavenly targets. When the James Webb Space Telescope is fully operational, it will be able to look back in time to possibly 100 million years after the Big Bang, which is a great milestone considering it will offer scientists and other space exploration agencies more insight to what the universe was 100 million years after the Big Bang, which is amazing. Thank you for viewing another episode of Space Light while you're still here, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel, share, like, and comment. See you in the next video.